Welcome to today's coffee break. We are going to talk about the check ledger entry screen in this system. And the reason I want to sort of discuss it is there's a few unknowns about it. It's a pretty simple little screen. One of the things is that the only way to get to it is through the actual bank account card. There are many areas of the system where you can sort of navigate your way through the system and get to the same screen from different places. This isn't one of those. If you want to get to the check ledger entry screen, you need to go to the bank account card. So I'm going to go ahead and open up my bank account. And then I'm going to go to navigate and check ledger entries. All right. So what this does is it shows you a posting of all the different checks for this particular account. I'm just going to resort this. No, that's right. And what I really want to draw your attention to is the entry status. So this is a question we get pretty frequently. What is the difference between financially voided and voided? Well, voided would be if you had suggested your payments in the payment journal, then you had printed your checks and the printer ate your checks, you would want to void them. So what that does is it voids them and keeps track of the check number that was consumed. And that way we have a sort of a register of everything that's happened with all of our checks. We don't have any missing checks out there. Financially voided means that you created your payment journal, you printed your checks, you posted them. And after the financial impact of the posting, so the posting hit the bank account, the vendor account, maybe the customer account, if there was a refund, it also hit the general ledger. That means it's had a financial impact. And when you void it, it reverses those, or actually it doesn't reverse those, it puts in reversing entries. So I just want to show you how that works. So if I go to a posted check from here, I can void that check. So what it does is it comes up with a void date, which is the date of the original, the posting date on the check. And the default is to unapply and void the check, which is my preference. So the unapply and void means it will void the check. And if the check was applied to any invoices, it will basically open those back up. It will unapply them. And that way they're available to either be printed again, or if you need to issue a credit memo, you can then apply it to that invoice. So we want the unapply and void so that it gives us options with whatever documents the check was originally applied to. We have options to address those. So depending on what's happening here, you're probably gonna need to either, like I said, issue a credit memo or issue another check against those invoices. So I go ahead and click yes. And now this has changed to financially voided. And that's because it had already been posted and there was a financial impact, and that's what's been reversed, right? So I hope that helps you a little better understand the check ledger entry screen and the tools that are available and, of course, what you're seeing. That concludes today's coffee break. Thanks.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.